All your dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. We decided to hit the road to Naivasha to find one man who knows this too well. It is 11:30 a.m. We are ushered in at the Kenya Wildlife Service Training Institute in Naivasha by Godfrey Ipalei, the ICT administrator, and trainer's zeal to ensure his students achieve greater heights remains undeterred.
Type these words: Kenya Wildlife Service Training Institute is located in Naivasha.
Born in 1965 in Kolanya village, Busia County, with a physical disability, Ipalei has opted to view his physical state as a blessing rather than a shortcoming.
I normally joke and say I was born at lunchtime when God was creating, then he went for lunch and forgot to finish. But that's a joke.
His courage proved his strength as he was growing up at a time when the community treated persons living with disabilities as second-class citizens.
But kids who are worse, they'll run and come close and say, "Hi, look at this person, and yes, I doesn't have hands, doesn't have hands," and they think they are hiding.
And so they say it the way it is.
They say it the way it is. So for me, I've overgrown it. I don't shout to anyone. In fact, for kids, I like it, because when they say like that, I say, "Hey, come, see these hands," and then they become free. They'll come and touch, and it's over.
The University of Nairobi graduate, however, looks at his state from a different perspective.
People have offered to give me artificial hands, but I always feel I'll be more disabled with artificial hands than this. So I'm not disabled, I'm just unique.
The senior bachelor who harbors intentions of getting a life partner in the near future is totally independent when it comes to house chores.
I do everything. I wash my clothes myself. I iron my clothes myself. I cook myself. How my father used to wash his inner clothes. He would press them with his hand on the basin like this and turn. And that is how I wash my clothes today. On the collar where it is dirty, I put on my hand and I, like this. That is how I wash clothes today.
His gratification, he says, comes when he performs his best.
And today my handwriting is not a ringy, but it is so beautiful. I use both hands to write, and I write very, very, very neatly. And that is how I went to school. I went late, 9 years old. That's when I went to class one. There was no baby school, blah, blah.
The award-winning author has so far had two of his books published, one being Mlemavu Si Mimi, which scooped the Jomo Kenyatta Award for Literature in 2011. He loves football, and he was named the best male player for Mazingira Sevens in 2008. His hard work and determination has earned him a head of state commendation by retired President Mwai Kibaki. Back home in Busia County, the man who is so passionate about education has a project as a way of giving back to the community.
So we started from our church, Salvation Army, Kwalanya. There are rooms there that were for the schools that are Kwalanya there. So they were all starting from the church. So we rented those rooms. I started as ECD. Then later on, my brother tells me, "Hey, the parents have refused, their kids cannot go to public schools. So we must have them in from class one." So started like that. So today, this year, we are examining class 8.
He is also a motivational speaker who loves imparting a positive attitude in youngsters.
I've gone to several schools. Those schools have reported. The schools I can even name. I went to Kambani. There's a school, a secondary school called Iani Secondary School. Iani Secondary School used to get D's. I went there early last year with the MP of that constituency. She's called the Honorable Jessica Mbalu. She did not invite me. I was invited by KWS, my colleague at KWS. She had been invited to go and give a motivation talk during a parents' day. Then she realized, how will I go and say? So she invited me. Then the MP met me there. And so she called me back to go to that school. That school last year got 12 B pluses. And this year they're expecting A. So I went there again early this year.
His love for nature is what perhaps saw him choose a career that would see him work closely with the Kenya Wildlife Service.
Because I also like visiting. I like environment. I like nice places, watching birds. I just like trees, sitting somewhere like this. That's what I like. I think that's why I joined KWS. I don't know. I think that's why I joined KWS. Although we are stepping on grass, I don't like stepping on grass. I like following the paths. Because I feel like they're feeling itchy. They're feeling bad. So those are the things I like.
I'm beautiful and capable of being the best me I can. And I love myself just the way I am. And I love myself just the way I am.